Welcome back to Armchair Directors. It's time for The Right Direction, and this week, since we did the advanced preview of Scream 4, we thought we would point you in the direction of the original Scream trilogy.
For sure. It is available now on Blu-ray, and the movies hold up pretty well all these years later. The first one is still...
All these years later. It's been, what, almost a decade now.
Yeah, I was going to say a decade and a bit. But in movie time, that can be a lot of time. That's I've seen true. Movies from 2002 that just don't hold up.
That's true.
So it's nice that Ghostface still is scary.
Yeah.
A lot of the pop culture references in the first one are still spot on. Even movies that have come since these conventions have been, you know, exposed. A lot of movies still follow those conventions, so it's still nice to watch Scream turn them on its ear. And it was one of the first groundbreaking movies that, you know, it wasn't just one killer. It was the two-killer concept, which has been exploited heavily since. But slasher movies before, one killer was at work. So when Scream broke new ground with two killers, it was kind of cool.
And it's also cool to watch a movie that's not like 30 years old. That's only like 10 or 15 years old. And see a lot of people who have risen to prominence.
Yes.
Get their start in these movies. One I can think of in particular is The Shermanator. He's in one of those original ones, right?
Yeah.
From American Pie.
Yep.
There's a lot of people who are just going to pop up and you go, oh yeah, he was in that.
And throughout the whole series, there's lots of people. Omar Epps is in Scream 2 and now, you know, he's on House every week.
Yeah.
Patrick Dempsey was in Scream 3 before he was McDreamy, it was cool to be Patrick Dempsey again.
Yeah.
So it's cool watching these movies, and there are faces that in the years since Scream have really gone on to become superstars. And same with Scream 4, there's going to be people like that.
And there's one star in particular that went on to become a superstar and then went on back down to be in Scream 4.
Yeah.
You know, just kidding. We love you, Nev. We love you, Nev.
And, you know, the same, I guess, could be said for David Arquette. What has he done lately other than
He's never been
out. Rehab.
He was WCW World Champion.
Oh, there's that.
For what that's worth.
There's that.
All right, on to viewer mail. Antoine627 makes a comment about my short film, Marvin. He says, I like it. It had a very, very good pacing. I've never watched Dexter. However, you didn't need to know about it to enjoy it. You have talent, Michael. Well, thank you. My wife said that I have the same obsession with Stallone. As you see in the Marvin short, the one guy has an obsession with Val Kilmer. I was actually thinking of doing a follow-up to Marvin with Stallone as the next subject matter, so it's interesting that you mentioned that. And Spartan sucked. Wow.
I thought Spartan was awesome.
I love Spartan for one line. Val Kilmer asks somebody something, and then he says, confirm that you understand me! Confirm that you understand me! I use that one all the time on movie sets. And where did you get VHS tape? LOL. And could you please post more of your Right Direction segment on YouTube? I can't wait until you guys go national, then I can watch your show here in Texas. We're looking forward to going national and worldwide soon, too.
And if we do, we will let you know.
Absolutely. Thanks.
Totes1829 says of our Battle Los Angeles movie review, I mean, District 9 was awful, though. Say what?
I mean, it's weird when people start sentences with, I mean. I mean, thanks for the comment.
Well, thanks for the comment. I definitely think you would be in the minority of people who didn't like District 9.
I mean, I thought District 9 was great.
And enough making fun of that. Moving on.
Mr. T66 says, hey, did you guys see Captain America trailer? Actually, yeah, we did. I thought it looked awesome. I know you guys are picky about tone, but the tone on this one looks consistent, unlike Green Lantern. It's not so much that we're picky about tone. It's just that you need a consistent tone to have a good movie. I mean, that's like saying I'm picky about not having fecal matter in my food. You know,
right.
I'm not. It's just it shouldn't be there.
It shouldn't be there.
And
it shouldn't be an issue.
Tone should be consistent. It looks fantastic in Captain America, though. It looks really good.
Yeah, I think it looks awesome. Curly Fryest said of our Insidious review, what would you say to people that think it's a copy of The Haunting in Connecticut? I would say it is not a copy of The Haunting in Connecticut. This movie goes off on some tangents that Haunting in Connecticut definitely did not. And Haunting in Connecticut, I thought, was average at best. And Insidious is awesome.
Bruno Rubio says about our Sucker Punch review, any review that references Muppet Babies is expletive. which I think he means in a positive way. Great job. Thank you.
Spades and Sinners of Sucker Punch said, "Ah, Rolly, why hast thou not brought thy slippers back to your good master, Sir Michael? Thy cuteness is no excuse for thine laziness. You shall be deprived of the royal kibble. Now hence, we shall bring out thine Muppet babies for a many-hour marathon consisting of popcorn and the like."
Ah, yes. Where is my martini glass with root beer? Because I'm straight edge.
Taking it to a whole new level.
Sabra Huff says about Sucker Punch, "Great review, guys. I can tell the two of you have fun, and that's what it's all about." Well, it's
certainly... Which hopefully they could tell by the pronunciation of their name after we nailed it and now continually fudge it on purpose.
Well, it's nice to have fun talking about the movie because it sure as heck was not fun to watch it.
Dave4096 says of Sucker Punch, "Wow, thanks for the warning. I was hesitant about this one. Now I don't think I'll even pirate it."
That is a real slap in the face to the movie studios. "I'm not even going to steal your movie."
Oh my gosh.
It is not even worth stealing. Ecoming10 says about Sucker Punch, "Blue parts dangling, brilliant, and better than you." Thank you.
Extra Kurt says also of Sucker Punch, "Awesome take on this, and the Muppet Babies comparison is brilliant. Kudos, Mike."
Well, thank you very much. Your Imaginary Enemy, that's a great name, says about Sucker Punch, "Another great review, good sirs. Hope you continue to do more reviews in character in the future." It's really amazing the positive response we've gotten to the snobberific duo.
They were almost universally hated the first time they appeared.
But the opinions have changed this time, and I think next time we do a Turd Alert, maybe we'll have to break out M. Cran and Sir Michael.
We'll see. Dottore Guzman Rules said of Sucker Punch, "Good one, guys. Nice impersonation, Mercy. I didn't know you could pull off a snobby English accent." That's actually not an impersonation or anything like that. It's his usual accent. He just dumbs it down for when we do the normal reviews.
Yes, much like how Christian Bale uses an American accent when he does press for his movies in the States. Mm-hmm. This is my true accent, and I use the Canadian accent when I'm on the show.
Yeah.
But thank you for your comment. And to close it off, Antoine627, you see how easily I just go right back into the fake accent? He says, "LOL, you guys are funny. I guess that Zach went the way of Sin City Frank Miller's mess. A Sucker Punch to the crotch, Rolly fetch my slippers," funny stuff. Yeah, the first time I saw the Sucker Punch trailer, that's exactly what I thought. Oh no, this looks like Sin City, which I hated, but I gave Zach the benefit of the doubt because 300 looked like that too and it was so fantastic. Watchmen looked like that too and it was really good, 4-star movie. Sucker Punch definitely was like Sin City though. So thanks a lot for all your comments. Really appreciate it. Keep them coming. And we want to plug our podcast once again. We've decided every other week we're going to be doing extended versions of the podcast with
brand new content,
supplementary materials, new reviews, comments, and we're going to have a contest too.
We will. So in our new podcast, there is a contest. So listen to the podcast. You can enter to win a couple Blu-rays. So check it out.
Thanks a lot for watching, and until next time,
enjoy the show. How it feels.